Hello guys, so in the previous video you have seen that we were working on a small case or small problem of a gym in which we have seen there was some problem, and to solve that problem now we'll be writing the code in R Studio. And for that problem we are taking some data. You can see here that we have created three groups: group 1, group 2 and group 3. Group 1 is a people of youngsters, group 2 are the senior uncles, and the group 3 are the senior citizens. So group 1 people wants to perform muscular exercises, and group 2 wants to perform cardio exercises, group 3 want to perform yoga exercises. Now when someone came to a gym trainer and asks him that the person want to add in a group, the gym trainer always represent the full group with a average value of their age, and the new request will be transferred to that which is matching according to his age. For example, if someone is coming to a gym trainer and asking him that he want to do exercises, then gym trainer ask him what is his age. The person if replied back that his age is 21, then gym trainer will be matching the mean of each group. For example, the mean of group 1 is 21, and then it check the mean of group 2, it find it 48.5, and it find the mean of group 3, and he finds it that it is 68.5. So accordingly he respond that the person if wants to go to a gym and his age is 20, so the group, the mean which matches near to it, that is group 1, so he will be assigning the person in that group. So it means the gym trainer will be replying back with the average value of a group to define that the name of a group or to define the particular group. Now as in the problem we have seen the two kung fu masters came and wants to perform some muscular exercises, and the gym trainer added them in a youngsters group according to their exercise requirement, because they were saying that they wanted to perform muscular exercises, and in gym they were giving the muscular exercises only for the youngsters group. So that is why the kung fu masters have been added in that group. Now before adding the kung fu master, we are saving the mean of the group, and the mean of group was 20. Remember this, before adding the kung fu master in group 1, the mean of the group is 20. Now we are adding the kung fu masters, one has an age of 100, other has an age of 102 in the group 1, and after then the mean is converted to 38. Remember this, before it is 20 and after it is 38. Now after 1 month we have seen that Mr. George came to gym and having age 38 and wants to work out with the same age group people. Now gym trainer matches the age of Mr. George with the group means as he was doing earlier. So according to the group mean, he found group 1 suitable for him. For example, see this, that first of all gym trainer had found the mean of group 1 which is 38, then he had found the mean of group 2 which is 48.5, and then he had found the mean of group 3 which is 68.5. Now as Mr. George's age is near to the group 1's age or is exactly 38, so what he will be giving him, he will be saying that you will be going in group 1 and that this group is more suitable for it for you, because its people have the age related to your age. Then gym trainer has assigned Mr. George with the group 1 people and he have assigned that data. After 3 days Mr. George came back wearing waist belt, neck belt, and is talking about to sue the gym trainer for giving him or recommending him the wrong group. Now wrong suggestion of exercising with group 1, which makes gym trainer to feel and check that why such problem happened. So for that gym trainer, what he have seen, he have opened the group 1 data, and once he had opened the group 1 data, what he sees that this person is a Mr. George. Before him in this group there was no one with having the age of 38, then how come the gym trainer have assigned him or recommending him that group in which no people is of his age, which makes him surprised and feel that what he was doing earlier, was it correct or it is wrong. So it means the values 100 and 102, maybe these values lead it to reach a wrong output. Can mean don't work at such places, and can we find such problematic values from data? If we can find them, then what we call them, and how can these values be traced in the future? For this, then the data scientists that have been hired have been explained the full case, and is telling that the data what you are working on has two persons in that group, that is of 100 and 102. These two persons are shifting your data towards to the right skewness, which means your data is now being converted to outliers. And for working on this type of a data, you can view this data, these outliers, with the command of box plot, and you can see your full data is lying in this range, but these two people are lying in this range. Due to them, your rest of your data is together, but because of these Kung Fu masters, these are leading your data to move toward the right side, and we can get it clearly visualized via this density plot, where it directly shows that the main data or the full data set is working here, but because of these two values, the data is moved toward this, and hence your mean will be moving towards somewhat in this side, and it is called right skewness of the data. Now it means mean would be giving wrong value if any value is out of range, which is called outliers. So it means mean can be giving you the wrong value if in the data you are entering the value which is out of range. So mean, I have told you that to remember this, the mean before adding Kung Fu Master was 20, which was correct, because you can see if Kung Fu Masters would not be added in this data, the central point is this, and we can define the full group by 20. But once a Kung Fu Masters have been added in this data, this mean will be shifted somewhere to here, which means that the central point is this, which is not correct. Hence, you can see mean after adding Kung Fu Master is 38, which is wrong, and that is due to the outliers, and this is called skewness of data. Now, that skewness and outliers can be detected with box plot. It can be detected with density plot also. Now, the question arises that if the outliers exist in data, do they exist with negative values also? So, we are creating a variable outliers one data, and we can see, and we are creating a box plot of it, that negative values can also be outside the range and positive value can also be outside the range, and the values those are outside the range will be called as outliers. So now the new question arises is, if we know that because of mean we are giving the wrong group to the person, so what will be our solution, what we need to give, and how we can select the best recommended group for the person? So can we tackle with these type of outliers? The answer is yes, we can tackle it, and we can tackle it by changing the type of average, because earlier we were using mean, which is subjected and which changes with the outliers. So we need to be use that type of average which is not working with outliers. It means we need to work on different type of average. Second thing, or we can remove these type of outliers, or we should be imputing them. Now, so the solution which we need to try is the other type of averages. So beside to mean, what are other type of averages? These are median and mode. So we need to be trying what is median, and we will be learning what is median. Mean of group 1, we can say it is 38, whereas median of group 1 is 20. If you remember, the mean of group 1 before adding Kung Fu Masters was also 20, and you can see median of group 1 after adding Kung Fu Master is still 20. So it means if at that point of time the gym trainer have find the median instead of mean for that groups, then might be Mr. George will be going in a correct group. He will not be going in a group 1, then he would be going in group 2, where he will be getting the cardio exercises. So I think you might be getting my point, what I want to say is. So the point is, instead of mean, if you would have given median, then the answer might be correct. But the point is, would median would be giving you always the correct output? And what is a median? So for that, what we are doing is, we have created a variable here, median. You can see it. We have created a variable here, a median, median 1. Now for this, what is a median is, a median Median is also a center value, and how we calculate it, we will be taking the full data set in a sorted manner, and from the sorted values we will be finding the center value. The center value will be taken as a median. So in this data there are 18 values, and accordingly we will be adding the center value. So for according to 18th, the ninth value should be the center value, and because these values are number of values are even in number, so what we'll be doing, we'll be adding the center two values and divided by 2. That means we'll be adding 31 plus 3 and divided by 2, and hence the value which we'll be getting is will be called as a median. So we can see mean of median 1 is 17, whereas median of median 1 is also 17. So in this data, if you are finding the median, that will be 17, and if you are finding the mean also, that would also be 17. Now mean and median can both be equal. Yes, it can be possible that mean and median can be equal, but if subjective to their outliers, if there will be outliers, big values here, then median will be different and then mean would be different. But if the data set is fine and mean and median are equal, hence you can say that values will not be having a huge outliers, or value will not be having a outliers. Now mean and median both are equal, checking count of the elements in median 1. So is median would always be right? Now the question arises to it that we are saying that mean, because of mean we are getting the wrong output, and because of the mean Mr. George had got the wrong group. So would median would be fine for this? Yes, in our case the median was giving us the correct output, but would median will be fine always? So for that we are checking this. In the median 1 dataset, this dataset, there are total 18 elements. Now 19 element I am entering it as 3, and then I am sorting the variables. After sorting it, I am checking the length of the variables. Now it is 19, and what is the median now? It is now 3. You can see it, before adding 19th value it was 17, after adding 19th value it is 3. And if 19th value I am making it as 31, I am sorting it now and I am taking the length is total 19, and now the median is 31. So you can see that the median, if 19th value is a small value, then the median is 3. If 19th value is a big value, then the median is 31. And if there are total 18 values, then the median is 17. Hence sometimes median also shifts. So what we can say that length, hence mean and median both deviates according to the values and the count of values in the sample. So it means median would also not be correct always. So getting my point, in our case, in the previous example of a gym, the solution would be given by a median also, that would be fine. But we cannot say that median would always be fine if mean was not correct, working correctly. Okay, so if median is not working correctly, then which average is next? So the next average will be called as mode. Now what do we mean by mode? Mode is a type of average which would be finding the maximum frequency of an element. For example, if in a data set there are values like 1, 1, 1 and 2, 2, if 1 is repeating more number of times, so the mode of that data set would be 1. The one which will be having maximum frequency will be the mode for the data set. Okay, so we are finding the mode. For example, we have a group 1. In group 1, the values are like this: 19, there are 2 people of 19, 20, there are 4 people of 20 ages of age, and there is 1 person with 22 years of age, 1 is 38 years of age, and 1 is 100 year of age, and 1 is 102 years of age. Now according to the question which we are working earlier, we will be solving it with mode also. But before it, we will be solving mode, that we will be learning it, what is mode. So we have created a variable mode 1 in which we have saved these variables, and we have created one is mode 2. By default in R there is no function of mode, so we are creating this function by ourselves. You can see this, that how we have created it, it is simple subsetting. So we have created this function. Now for this data set I want to find the mode, and the mode is the number of the maximum number of the variables, the maximum frequency of the variables in a data set. So 7 is 1, 9 is coming twice, 10 is coming 4 times, 11 is coming twice, and 13 is coming 1 time. So hence the for mode 1 data set, the mode will be 10. Fine. And similarly for mode 2, if we want to find it for mode 2, it would be 9, 10, 11, because 9 is of coming twice, 10 is coming twice, and 11 is also coming twice. So it means mode will be 9, 10 and 11. Anyone will be taken as a mode value. Now if we are taking about the gym problem, according to a gym problem, the question was this, did there were people of youngsters in which we have added some Kung Fu masters, and later on Mr. George, with 38 years of age, we have find the mean of this group, and we have, according to that mean, we have added him in the group, because mean was 38 and the person is also 30, age was also 38. So we have matched these things and we have sending this group. But the group was not suitable for him because he wants a cardio exercises and he wants exercises for his age. But the there is none of the person which is of 38 years of age. So now what you can see, that if no one is matching this age, then how can we can say that the average is 38? So the point is, no one have the value 38 in it. Whereas whenever we are finding the mode, the value will always be coming from the data set. It cannot be coming outside from the data set. For example, if now I am finding the mode of group 1, the output is 20. You might be remembering when we find the median of group 1, it was also 20. So it means at that point of time, either the gym trainer can be giving the mode value or it can be giving the median value. Both would be correct, and at that point of time Mr. George will not be seeing that type of frustratedness. Now if mode equals to 20, what does it mean? It defines that this group have mostly people of 20 years of age. Are you getting what I'm saying? Is so the what was the question in the gym case? The question was, we need to assign new people in that group which have the maximum number of people of that age. That is, agar koi banda hamare paas aa raha hai and he want to go for a gym, then we will be assigning him that group jisme uski age wale group wale bande hain jo wo zyada hone chahiye. So accordingly, agar main uska mod nikalta hu, mod will be telling me that that is the maximum frequency of the people that are in that group. Or now if mode equals to 20, what does it mean? That in this group, the more number of people are of 20 years of age, not 38 year of age. So 38 year old person would restrict himself to gym with them and would try to find a better group. So the output of that gym one case would be found in a better way via using median or via using mode, and mode would be the much better option than median also. Now the question arises, we have seen that mean have a problem, we have seen that a median have a problem, do mode have a problem or not, or we will be using always mode? So what we are doing is, we are creating three groups, group 2P1, we are group 2P2, group 2P3. And we have created a box plot of P3, and we can see that there is an outlier in P3. Then we have seen the mean of P1, mean of P2, mean of P3, each one have mean value same. We are finding the median of P1, median of P2, median of P3, each of them have a same median. And then we are finding the mod for this. Mod for P1 is 10, mod for P2 is 9, 10, 11, and mod for P3 is also 10. So what I want to say is, this can be the situation that sometimes your mean would be same, your median would be same, your mod would be same, and at that point of time you need to check which one is fine. Is finding mod is always right? If no, then which average would be used to be used at various which place? That is the main question that arises everyone mind, that which type of average needs to be used at which type of place, and that depends on your data. So in our next video, we'll only be focusing on that which average will be used at which point and which average will not be using at other point. So thanks for listening this video and take care, stay safe.